Let's stand up, let's get fired up for Roald Amundsen High School.
Has impacted their lives. We're here to examine what we've done to tackle this issue. Play the video. Reducing the impacts of ineffective lighting. Our mission is to educate the community about the importance of preserving the night sky and to advocate for dark sky friendly policies in order to mitigate the harmful effects of light pollution.
As a group, we face an array of challenges. For example, personnel change made it very difficult for us to establish a great team. But by filling in their positions and actually progress as a result. Another problem that we faced was actually, well, determining our challenge. But through some back and forth, we finally decided on the issue that is light pollution.
In order for us to learn how light pollution was affecting our community, we traveled in search of dark skies. For example, Amy visited Central Illinois to see how rural areas experience light pollution. But our curiosity didn't end there. Dylan ventured to Costa Rica to also experience a dark sky. He too was able to inform our decision making in the process. Through these citizen science projects, we have been able to better inform ourselves on the impact of light pollution in our community.
To engage the community, we visited schools and talked to them about light pollution, astronomy, and Starry Chicago. We also set up social media with a Twitter, Facebook page, Instagram, and website. Okay. We engaged kids through fun workshops that taught them about the stars and about the harmful effects of light pollution and the importance of preserving the night sky. The culminating event was a star party. For many kids and adults, this was the first time they'd looked through a telescope or seen the moon up close.
To advocate for our sky, to advocate for our cause, Justin and I attended a Chicago Infrastructure Trust meeting where we voiced our concerns about Chicago's lights. What we told the council members was that street lights are much more effective when they are shielded under a proper design, which reduces light pollution. We believe that they heard our concerns and they will be implemented in Chicago's new lighting plan. In addition, we prepared a model lighting ordinance and are pursuing meetings with local elected representatives.
Starry Chicago's educational program teaches kids about the night sky and light pollution. Students who attend our workshops also become star ambassadors who can then take their education to their classroom and to peers. Additionally, we are developing a telescope loaner program so the families of star ambassadors can experience the star night sky for themselves.
Our program is replicable because we are able to teach other high school students to teach kids about the night sky, and we are able to...
Time's up. Man, I was really getting excited about the light pollution. Let's give them a round of applause.
Younger kids about the night sky, to get them excited about the night sky and be concerned about light pollution. We have several star ambassadors at different elementary schools, and they will basically teach their peers about light pollution and the importance of it, the harmful effects, and some solutions to it, and they may even become workshop leaders themselves. We also plan to spread awareness about the night sky, the dark sky, and take kids on trips to different places in the countryside so that they are able to experience a true dark sky for themselves. And we plan to get funding from grants in order to fund those trips.
So Dave Lang challenges to illuminate the unknown in our community. The destruction of Chicago's night sky is the unknown. Through our workshops, outreach to policymakers, and a curriculum, we will build a better Chicago. We must pay attention to the anthropogenic factors that plague our planet. We must look up into the night sky and understand that change begins today.
Great job. I read that Natalia G's dry wit and fearlessness inspired you all to go beyond your limitations. So I'm really curious, tell us about something that you all did that you just didn't think at the outset of this process you could ever do, and what that's taught you about what's possible in life. Something that happened, something you accomplished in these last 7 weeks.
There are several things that we didn't expect to happen. So one of the things in our social media, we created a website and several accounts in social media to really have a virtual presence, especially with getting us out there. And it was really interesting because when we checked yesterday, we had like over 500 followers on Instagram. And even with like the Chicago Infrastructure Trust, we were so fortunate to have like, the opportunity to even influence like, legislative process, and to be able to be part of that that event and that meeting was a great accomplishment. And also yesterday, we also had an interview with DNA Info, and I mean it's really interesting just seeing how much we progressed and how much we've grown.
Yeah. One more question.
What impact do you think the branding of Starry Night and social media and the t-shirts and all the things you did had as an influence to your community?
One of the things that we found at our event was that the kids had never seen the night sky and what we were able to give them, which was very, you know, astronomical. They saw the Jupiter and the moon. And, you know, we found that the kids were extremely happy. They were screaming, you know, mommy, daddy, like, this is my first planet. Like, I saw Jupiter, right? And so we found that it was like really influential to the kids and really got them excited when they were able to see things that they that had always been there before, but they had never actually been able to see before. So,
all right, let's give them a